ग्रेड 5 स्टूडेंट्स. हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. ओपन पेज नंबर 49 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक. पेज नंबर 49. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. सी इफ़ यू कैन फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स इन द फॉलोइंग. द फर्स्ट हैज़ बीन डन फॉर यू. कंट्री एडजेक्टिव. हाउ कैन वी रिकग्नाइज An Englishman that where he or she live? He or she live in England. Now Pakistan. What are living in Pakistan are called? Pakistani. 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 Iraq, Iraqi. Spain, Spanish. Germany, German. China, Chinese. France, French. Holland, Dutch. DUTCH. Africa, African. Italy, Italian. Canada, Canadian. America, American. Okay, students, question number 5. Write the singular of these nouns. The first has been done for you. Leaf, leaves. Wolf, wolves. Half, halves. Child, children. Shelf, shelves. Live, lives. Calf, calves. Woman, women. Exercise C. Pronouns. What are the pronouns? Pronouns are the words which we use instead of a noun. Underline all the pronouns in the following sentences. She lived in France many years ago. Which is the pronoun she? Underline it. One day another country attacked her beloved France. Her. The soldiers came and burnt its villages. Its. John met the general. She asked him for a horse. She, him. Then she rode it into battle. She. She beat the army which was attacking them. She, which, them. Unfortunately, many people did not like her. Her. They thought she was a witch. They, she. Now turn the next page, page number 50. Underline the adverbs in the following sentences. Shireen walked slowly down the street towards the river. Slowly. Towards. She put her feet into swiftly running water. Swiftly. Oh, she said, Cloud, it's very cold. Aloud. She said, aloud. Aloud is an adverb. Suddenly, she heard someone shouting loudly down the river. Suddenly, loudly. She ran quickly along the bank. Quickly. Now, prepositions. Put suitable prepositions in the blanks in the following sentences. It was very cold and Sarah was asleep - bed. In bed. Suddenly she heard a song from the room below her. She jumped out of bed and ran down the stairs. In the corner of the room was a huge snake. The snake turned and hissed at her. She picked up a stick and threw it at the snake. Okay, students, today we will start a new lesson, a new story, The Ambassador's Disguise. Page number 52. Once in the palace of Vladimir, a great Russian prince of Kiev, all the nobles were making boards. One noble boasted of his strength another showed of his wisdom, other boasted of their wealth or their trusted horses. Boast means to pray or to speak highly about anyone, to praise, to show love and care. This is the boast, to praise anyone. One noble, Stav Gojinovich, said nothing at all. He sat with a dreamy look on his face. Prince Vladimir noticed this and asked, "Why are you silent, Stav? Have you nothing to say?" "Great prince," replied Stav, "I have nothing to boast of except my wife, Katrina. She is young and beautiful, braver and more skillful than any warrior here. She can shoot with a bow, sing like a nightingale, and enchant everyone with her harp, and no one here will ever beat her at chess." "Is that so?" interrupted the prince. "Yes, indeed, great prince," replied Stav. "She could easily defeat all your nobles. And pardon me for saying so, great prince, but you are no match for her either." The prince became very angry when he heard this. He glared at Stav and said, "You have gone too far this time. How dare you say that I am no match of your wife?" The prince pointed a finger at Stav and, turning to one of his guards, said, "Take this man away. Throw him into the dungeon. Give him oats and water, nothing more. Now go." The guard did as he was instructed. He threw Stav into a cold, dark dungeon. The only light came from a small window with thick iron bars high up near the ceiling. All Stav could see was the sky. He sat on the cold stone floor, feeling very sad. At night, as night fell, Stav looked out of the window at the stars in the sky. "Alas," he thought to himself, "I have served the prince for 9 years, and this is how he repays me? I am sorry I hurt the prince, but I only spoke the truth about my wife. I hope someone tells Katrina where I am." Katrina heard what had happened to her husband. She tried to visit him the following day, but the guards would not let her in. So she thought of a plan to rescue him. Katrina called together her band of 30 archers, 30 chess masters, and 30 musicians. She told them she needed their help to rescue her husband, and she agreed to help, and they agreed to help her. The next day, Katrina got ready. She wore a suit of armor with a helmet to cover her face. She carried a bow and some arrows, a club of steel, it's a weapon, and a long lance, it's also a weapon. Perched on her left forearm was a falcon. She mounted a tall black horse. When her friends arrived, she set off for the palace leading them. Leading means following. They were following the Katrina. A short distance from the walls of the city, Katrina told her followers to wait. She rode by herself into the city and went to the great hall of the palace. All the people thought she was a great warrior. Of course, no one guessed she was a woman. Katrina bowed to Prince Vladimir. "I am the ambassador of the King of Greece," she announced. "I have come to collect tribute from you. If you refuse to pay, my army of 40,000 men will attack your city." Prince Vladimir trembled with fear. "Give me time to think, ambassador," he begged. "Time is precious," roared the ambassador. "I want your answer now. Pay the tribute or we will attack. If you cannot pay, then give me your niece, Zabawa, to be my wife." The prince's niece, Zabawa, was a beautiful and clever girl. The prince loved her dearly. There was nothing in the world he would do harm her. All this time, Zabawa was sitting in the great hall, watching and listening to all that was said. The prince asked her, "Beloved niece, only you can save us. What are we two to do?"
"Dear uncle," replied Zabawa, "I obey you in all matters, but I cannot marry a woman. This ambassador is not a man, but a woman. See how the ambassador talks and walks. Look at the ring marks on her delicate fingers."
"You might be right," agreed the prince, "but what we can do to find out if the ambassador is a man or a woman?" A little later, Prince Vladimir spoke to the ambassador.
"Dear ambassador," said the prince, "my niece is used to people with great skills. I can only allow her to marry you if you can show us you're skillful. Come, show us if you can play the harp." A harp was brought and Katrina began to play it and sing. The nobles were enchanted with the music, but no one could tell whether the ambassador was a man or a woman. Then the prince asked the ambassador to play a game of chess. The prince was the best player in the land. He believed if the ambassador was a woman, she would lose. Much to the prince's astonishment, the ambassador won the game. The prince turned to the Zabawa. "This is no woman," he whispered.
"I'm sure she is," replied Zabawa. The prince thought for a while, then said to the ambassador, "Let us have a trial for archery." The prince, the ambassador, and the nobles all went outside into a large country. A golden ring was set up at one end, and the prince placed a steel knife behind. First, the prince shot 3 arrows at the target. The arrows passed
through the rings, but did not hit the knife. Then the ambassador shoot an arrow at the ring. The arrow hissed like a snake as it flew. It passed through the ring and cut into itself too against the edge of the knife. The prince was now sure that the ambassador was a man, but Zabawa still did not agree with him.
"I shall not marry a woman," she cried. "The ambassador may shoot arrows just like a man, but he talks, walks, and sits just like a woman." The prince became angry.
"You are being silly," he said. "I order you to marry the ambassador. Go, prepare for your wedding." Zabawa ran off in tears. The prince told the ambassador that his bride would soon be ready. But Katrina decided to put an end to this game. She said to the prince, "Before the wedding, let us fight each other. Let us see who is stronger." Trembling at this suggestion, the prince said, "Ambassador, there is no one here who is your match."
"Oh dear," replied Katrina, "is there no one? I was looking forward to some sport. Perhaps there is a brave warrior in your dragons who could fight me."
"Yes, yes, there is," said the prince, smiling and remembering Staff Godinovich. He immediately ordered his guards to bring Staff from his dungeons. Soon Staff Godinovich arrived. He was ordered to put on a suit of armor and mount a horse. When Staff was ready, he and the ambassador galloped into a nearby field. All the nobles went to watch the great fight. The ambassador and the Staff rode towards each other and then leaped from horse to horse. They threw their steel clubs in the air and then rode straight towards the prince. The terrible ambassador of Greece took off her helmet and threw it at the feet of the prince. Katrina's beautiful long hair fell down over her shoulders. The nobles gasped in surprise.
Great prince," laughed Katrina. "I have rescued my husband from your dungeons. You must agree.
He was right to boast of my skills. Now, farewell. All laughing together, Katrina and Staff, Godimir rode away. Okay, students, story was very interesting. It's about an ambassador, this guy. His wife was very brave. He can play games. He can play chess very well. He can do everything. Now, what you have to do is, you have to take out your notebooks, write down lesson number 5, the ambassador disguise, vocabulary words, ambassador, boast, club, silent, tribute, enchant, delicate, believed. Okay, students, these are vocabulary words. You have to write and learn on your notebook. Next, what you have to do is, write words meaning. Words, boast, to praise, tribute, an act, a statement, or a gift, to show love and respect for someone, especially for a dead person. Delicate, fine in texture, structure. Disguise, to hide something or change it. These are the words meaning you have to write on your notebook. The last homework is word sentences. You have to make sentences of these words. Boost, tribute, delicate, disguised, believed. Okay, students, have a great day. Keep smiling. Allah Hafiz.